put me in the movies. They're gonna make a big star out of me. We'll make a film about a man that's sad and lonely. And all I gotta do is act naturally. Well, I'll bet you I'm gonna be a big star. Might win an Oscar, you can't.
Hello and welcome to Meet Me at the Movies. Noel T. Manning II here. Appreciate you tuning in for the Oscar special, the Academy Awards special. We've got a lot of critics coming in. They're going to give you their votes for individual categories and why. And they're also going to give votes for best film. And we'll tally that up and let you know the Meet Me at the Movies Oscar winner for best picture after it's all said and done. Do want to thank Matt Brunson for pitching this idea. We're going to have him on as well. So let's see who we've got in the green room. Tim, who's there? Mr. Thomas Manning, welcome to the Oscar special, Meet Me at the Movies. And I think you're going to be talking about, for this particular segment, best visual effects. Am I correct, sir?
Yeah, and otherwise I would be a bit thrown off by your British accent, but it actually plays into the filmmaker we're talking about. We're talking about Christopher Nolan's Tenet. Of course, Christopher Nolan, fantastic English director. And, you know, with Nolan, he's always going to find a way to do a very intriguing visual style with his films, whether it's spinning hallways in Inception or wormholes in Interstellar, or with Tenet, where you have the laws of physics are completely inverted. So from our perspective as a viewer, some of the characters and objects moving forward in time, and then other characters and objects are moving backward in time. And it's a beautiful, beautiful blend of practicality and digital visual effects. He has a way of making digital look so incredibly practical and practical look like something that you could only accomplish with digital. The way that he just brings it all together is, it just really boggles the mind. Within this film, you have reverse car chases, you have, you have gun play that's like with reverse bullets. You have a massive 747 plane that has crashed into a hangar. He said after he crunched the numbers that that would be easier to do practically rather than CGI. I don't know how that works, but I mean, I'll take Nolan's word for it. And I've never seen effects like this put to film. And it really just seems like the next step forward in what you can accomplish with VFX. And I don't think there's really been anything that's touched it this year.
Absolutely. And you know, when I think about Inception British, I think about Ted Lasso and you know, that old British, kind of upside down world. And Ted Lasso was definitely thrown into the upside down world. Also asking everybody, Thomas, who would they vote for best film for the Oscars?
Best film of the Oscar. I've got to go with Judas and the Black Messiah from director Shaka King, Lakeith Stanfield, and Daniel Kaluuya. I just got to give it to him.
Awesome. Thomas, thanks for joining us. And we're going to have you back, hopefully, talking about another category before this show wraps. We'll see what we can do. So go to the green room, and I'll try to call you back, man.
All right. See ya.
Well, look who it is. It is the man whose idea it was to do this show, Matt Brunson. Hey, buddy. How are you, man?
Hey, doing good. Nice to see you.
Hey, man, I appreciate you pitching this idea to me. And we were chatting back and forth about it. And I said, yeah, let's do this show, and talked about that at the top of the show as well. But thank you. I just wanted to thank you personally. And we're glad to have you here to talk about a category that you had first dibs, mm-hmm. and you said best original screenplay. So dive into this category and tell me who you would vote for and why for our Oscar special.
Okay. Yeah, as a writer, it seemed like the logical choice. it's a very strong category this year, but my vote would definitely go to Emerald Fennell, or Fennell, not sure how you pronounce that name, for A Promising Young Woman. I'm in the minority. I don't think it was the best year for film. There are very few that like really either moved me or shocked me, stunned me, whatever. This one did all that. And what's really interesting, I mean, it's a pull no punches movie with Carey Mulligan giving a terrific performance as this woman who's getting her measure of revenge for a past wrong. But apparently the original screenplay ended at a really dark place, like just horrible. And then the producers or the people put the money were like, look, we're putting money into this. Let's have a little bit of, you know, hope in it. And what's good is they added this bit that I think strengthens the movie. And it's that you don't feel like it's added. It's really connected to the rest of the movie. So I just think it's just incredibly well written. It's just some shocking stuff in here. The character that Carey Mulligan, who I think deserves the Oscar, by the way, some of the stuff she does, you're like, whoa, I can't believe they're actually having a character do this. You're behind her all the way though. And it's a good movie.
Yeah, it is. And it's one of those that has continued to pick up steam throughout awards season. So your vote, Promising Young Woman, for Best Original Screenplay. So we're also asking, and this was your idea as well, to vote for Best Picture. Who would get your vote for Best Picture, Matt Brunson?
It would also be Promising Young Woman. I'd give it Picture, Actress, Director, and Screenplay.
Okay, awesome. Well, man, thanks for joining us. Always good to see you. And happy belated birthday to that beautiful young one that you have, the young Brunson that you have running around. Thanks for joining us, buddy.
Thank you.
Daryl Menzel, welcome to Meet Me at the Movies, the Oscar special. So glad to have you with us today. I dressed up just for you, and you dressed up just for me. So thank you, and welcome to talk about cinematography.
Thanks for having me. I'm always appreciative to have me to be on the show, man. It's always nice to meet at the movies.
That's it. So tell me about cinematography. What would you vote for and why?
Cinematography, man. We got some strong nominees here in cinematography. When it all boils down to it, I think it's going to come down to, I would vote for News of the World. A lot of great establishing shots, very pretty to look at. Plus, it's a good feel-good movie as well. It kind of went under the radar as far as like buzz and hype, but I really, really dig the visuals of News of the World.
Yeah, it was. I'm with you, man. It was an amazing film, and I think that it was underappreciated this year in a lot of different ways. I love the sound design. I love the score and the acting, of course, the young acting talent, unbelievable in this film. But yeah, cinematography, man. What was it about the cinematography that really spoke to you in News of the World?
I think it's because of the time period that it's set in. So, you know, we're in the late 1800s. The America, as we know it, hasn't been developed as of yet. So we have a lot of wide open, expansive scenery, and they take full usage of that expansive scenery just to give you as many pretty, beautiful, stark, this is what America was before you know it. They take full advantage of that.
Yeah. And you even get a sense of the dust storms and the nasty part of it as well. They cover the gamut from a cinematography standpoint. Mm-hmm. Good choice, good vote. And if you're going to vote for Best Picture, who would you vote for Best Picture? We're asking everybody to chime in on this.
Oof, it's rough, but I think in the end, I'm going to give the slight edge to Minari on this.
Awesome.
A beautiful showcase of the American dream as seen by people who you do not typically see on the screen, living the struggle of the American dream.
Daryl Menzel, thanks for joining us, buddy.
Thanks for having me. Y'all take it easy.
Hey, Nicole, good to see you. How are you? Nicole Ackman right here on Meet Me at the Movies, the Oscar special, the Academy Awards special, talking about individual categories. We have quite a few folks coming on today, including you. You're going to be talking about Best Costume Design, and we all know that that's a perfect choice for you to say who you would vote for and why.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for having me on and for letting me talk about this. I don't think it would shock anyone who knows me to know that I would absolutely vote for Emma for costume design. Alexandra Byrne is my favorite costume designer of all time, so it's kind of an easy pick for me. But I also think that Emma is such a perfect example of costume design doing exactly what it needs to be doing. I think that not only does it work together incredibly well with the production design to sort of create a world for these characters to live in, but also this is some of the most period accurate Regency costuming that we've ever seen on film. This is much more accurate than what we typically get in these Jane Austen adaptations. But also I think that one thing that Alexandra Byrne is really talented at is sort of using her costumes to help build character. And a lot of Emma is about class and social status. And the way that she uses the costumes to let us know who the wealthiest people in this town are and who the less well-off people are is really brilliant, because that influences every interaction that we see in the movie. And she also just does a great job at, you know, building all these characters through what they're wearing, whether that's the Eltons being sort of ridiculous in their costuming as they are in their character, yeah, or whether that's the fact that Emma looks so young and vibrant in, yes, everything that she's wearing, which is who she is.
So we're asking for also best picture vote. Who would you vote for best picture, Nicole?
My vote for best picture, hands down, goes to Promising Young Woman.
Okay, Promising Young Woman. So we are tallying the votes, and as the show wraps, we'll let you all know who our choice is. Thanks so much, Nicole, for joining us right here on Meet Me at the Movies, the Oscar special. So good to see you.
Thank you so much for having me.
Douglas Davidson, Double D. Good
hey,
to see
you,
man.
I'm doing awesome, good. How are you?
I'm awesome, man. Thanks for joining us for the Oscar special right here on Meet Me at the Movies. And your category, I think, is best dance number. Is that what we're talking about?
That's right. That's right. But you can't have a dance without a song.
That's right. You got best original song. Is that right? Is that your category?
Correct.
All right. Well, tell me that. Tell me the song and why.
For me, it's Fight For You by Her, which is representing Judas and the Black Messiah. It's a song which feels very much of the era in which the film takes place, but is incredibly modern, much like the film and the story that it's telling. So that's the song that gets my vote. Absolutely.
Yeah, very cool. It was actually a pretty cool year for song as well. I've been amazed when you look at the year we had from a pandemic standpoint. Mm-hmm. But so many great films, I thought, some great performances, great, yep, songs. Yep. I was pleased with the films we had this year. I really, really was.
Oh, and, yeah. Pandemic or no pandemic, there's still movies coming out.
Yes.
And we've had some phenomenal performances. It just meant that it was a little harder for some to be seen and a little easier for others.
Yeah. Yeah. So as we think about the best picture category, I'm asking everyone to also tell me, what would they vote for best picture?
Gave this a lot of thought, as this is probably the only time I'm going to the Oscars. Minari.
Minari, okay. Minari is getting some love. At the end of the show, we're going to tally all these up and we will see where we are. And Minari also got best film for the North Carolina Film Critics as well. So very good. Douglas Davidson, thanks for joining us, man. Good to see you as always.
Thank you for having
safe,
me.
Be safe, be happy, and just appreciate you, man.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Mr. Christian Jessup, so good to see you, buddy. Glad you could join us for this Oscar special. And of course, when I pitched this to you, I knew exactly which category you were going to choose. I had no doubt. Well, it was a toss-up between animation and score. And of course, you did choose score. So welcome. Really glad to have you. And so tell us about your vote for a best score for the Oscars, for the Meet Me the Movies Oscars, and why.
Yeah, so we've got some great nominees for the best score Oscar this year, but you know, I'm repping my favorite, which is Pixar's Soul. The music is absolutely wonderful. Whenever I'm looking at my favorite score for the year, I'm looking for how well it fits the film, and I'm looking for any standout musical moments. Soul kind of had an advantage from the start because it's a movie that very much has a focus on music, and so there's several moments in the film that have, you know, jazz solos that almost solely focus on the music. There's a wonderful moment towards the end of the film where Joe reflects on his time in the film and sits down and plays at the piano. And that moment just gave me chills watching it for the first time. And so I had to go with Soul as my favorite. The other nominees are great. I thought News of the World and The Five Bloods were very subtle scores. They fit the film well, but they didn't necessarily have many standout moments. I thought Minari and Mank had some standout moments. Mank especially, I thought, didn't always fit the tone of the film as well, but they did a great job recreating the 1930s and 40s aesthetic. But Soul, it kind of hit all the boxes for me as far as music goes, and I have to go with that one.
And such a beautiful film as well. It spoke and had messages throughout about life, about who we are and what our purpose is in life, and what that calling is. And sometimes we may not realize what it is until we get a chance to look at it in a different way. And you're right, the score absolutely covered that. So Soul is your vote for best score. What about for best film? If you had a chance to vote for best film, we're asking everybody, what would that be?
I had a chance to vote for best film, I would go with Promising Young Woman. Really enjoyed that one. I think it's possibly one of the best crowd pleasers that we've got out of this year's nominees as well. So.
Christian Jessup, thanks so much, buddy. Good to have you right here on the Meet Me at the Movies Oscar special. And look forward to having you back later on down the road.
Great to be here, Noel.
All right. Thanks so much to all the critics who are joining us for this special and for you who are tuning in to spend time hearing what we think about the Oscars. Thank you as well. We're taking a quick intermission. We're going to be back with much more right here on Meet Me at the Movies.
They're going to put me in the movies. They're going to make the big star.
Yeti Baseball is here. Our players are raring to go and swing for the fences. But Yeti Athletics isn't all that's great about Cleveland Community College. We offer a wide variety of programs for students of all ages. We'll help you train for a new job, gain more skills for a promotion, or get a head start on college credits. We know students learn in different ways. That's why we offer online and in-person classes. CCC, we can help you move forward safely. Visit clevelandcc.edu today and go Yetis.
Chef Paul Prudhomme once said, "You don't need a silver fork to eat good food." Well, on Cleveland County Kitchen, we don't have a silver fork, but we sure do serve up lots of good food. Hi, I'm Deborah Blanton. I hope you'll join me for the next Cleveland County Kitchen. Each month, we offer a complete farm-to-table experience. We visit local growers, we learn about nutrition, and wrap things up with wonderful meals prepared by our guest chefs. It's a lot of fun. I hope you'll join me for the next Cleveland County Kitchen.
They're gonna put me in the movies. They're gonna make the big...
Jane, it's Jane, it's Jane, it's Jane, it's Jane, it's Jane. We've known each other for over 30 years, and in college we talked movies, and here we are finally talking movies on Meet Me at the Movies, because you never accept my invites, so I'm glad you finally did. I'm glad you finally did, and you are the resident expert and the voting expert on Best Animated Feature, so who would you vote for and why?
Well, I did a binge watch of all of them at one time so that I could come up with a really informed decision. And it has to be Soul. It has to be Soul, because the movie has soul. I loved Wolfwalkers. I thought that movie was delightful. I love the guy that made that movie. He did another movie a few years ago that I loved. But watching Soul, I was entranced, I was fascinated, and it pulled at all the right heartstrings, and it was very, very powerful. I watched it with my teenage daughter. She and I were both crying at the end, and we came at it from different perspectives because she's a teenager and I'm an adult.
Yeah,
it was fantastic. If it doesn't win, I will be devastated.
Yeah, and just a perfect film across the board. You take animation out of the category, and it's still worthy of one of the best films of the year. And I'm with you. I love Soul, and that would have gotten my vote as well.
Yeah.
But we're also asking
from an animation standpoint, I will say that the Full Moon movie, I love the animation of that simply because it was so bright and colorful, and her costumes. I loved how in the credits they actually gave costume designer a credit. Yeah. In that movie, and that was wonderful. But from a pure storytelling whole package movie,
yeah,
Soul,
absolutely. Okay, who would you vote for Best Picture?
That's a tough one, but you know what, I love The Trial of the Chicago Seven.
Awesome. Jane Zabega, thank you so much for spending time with us right here on the Oscar special for Meet Me in the Movies. And
my
take
pleasure.
Care. Love ya.
Bye.
Hello. Hey, man. Eric Marchand. Good to see you, man.
Good
How
to
are
see
you,
you as well. I'm great. How are you?
Very, very good. Very glad you could join us for this Academy Awards special, spotlighting some of the categories. We're not going to get to all 522 of them, but we are going to get to a few of them. And you've got one that you've had a little interest in, and you've got a little bit of history you're going to share as well. So tell us about the category and who you would vote for, not who you predict who will win.
Who I think should win, not who I think is going to win. Okay, perfect. So best supporting actor has always been a category that I've found fascinating because it usually is reserved for the veteran actor who has had a long career that's never been nominated before, whether it's Walter Brennan being, you know, winning 3 awards and getting 4 nominations from the late 30s to the 40s, or whether it be Ben Johnson for The Last Picture Show, or, you know, Sir Michael Caine, or even somebody like James Coburn for Affliction. So that category is fascinating because it always kind of hooks into the kind of quote seasoned, you know, veteran actor. But for the 5 nominees in this category, I would say my personal favorite is Paul Raci for Sound of Metal, because it's not just a great subtle nuanced performance, it's also one that can easily be overlooked or sort of seen as a non-actor performance because it is so lived in and real. And obviously, you know, Paul Raci being the child of deaf parents, CODA, Children of Deaf Parents, of Deaf Adults, which is a movie that also played at Sundance this year, which I'm sure we'll be talking about next year. He brings a truth and honesty to the performance, and his scenes with Riz Ahmed are incredible.
Yeah, amazing film, amazing performance. So that is your vote if you were voting on the Academy. And we're also going to ask everybody to tell us who you would vote for Best Picture. No reason to tell us why, but what would be your vote?
You know, that's a really good question, but I'm also probably have to say Sound of Metal. I just think it's one of those movie experiences where I was lucky enough to see it at the Toronto Film Festival back in 2019.
Awesome. Eric Martian, thanks so much for joining us right here on Meet Me at the Movies. And people can find you on Cinema Scene. Stay safe, stay healthy, and thanks for joining us.
You too, my friend. Yeah.
Thomas, yeah, you're back from the green room. Glad you hung around. We've got you here talking Best Supporting Actress at this particular moment on the Meet Me at the Movies Oscar special. Give me your vote and why.
Yeah, so oftentimes comedy is kind of overlooked at the Oscars with a few exceptions. And one exception we did have in 2012, Melissa McCarthy was nominated for Best Supporting Actress for Bridesmaids. And we've seen a similar pattern here with Maria Bakalova for Borat, a subsequent movie film. And what she does comedically in this movie is some of the best work that I've seen in quite some time. I would say she outperforms Sacha Baron Cohen's comedy. Even though it's technically his film, his character is the title character, I believe that she is actually the main character and the heart and soul of this film. What she does, you know, physically, the physical comedy is just as incredible as what she does with her line delivery and the way that she adopts different personas within this fictional character itself.
Yeah.
There's just so many layers and so many nuances to it. And the way that she just kind of puts everything out there on the line, she does not hold anything back. But she still manages to stay in character, even when a lot of this is out in public with real people who don't know that she's doing a bit. And it's something just unfolding right before our eyes that it's almost difficult to comprehend. So I got to give it to Maria Bakalova.
Awesome. Awesome choice for Best Supporting Actress right here on the Meet Me the Movies Oscar special. And you did vote for Judas and the Black Messiah, I think, for Best Film. Have you changed your vote since we had you on earlier in the show, or is that still your vote?
I think I'm still going to go with Judas and the Black Messiah. So I guess that gives it 2 votes technically, maybe.
We'll see. Thanks, Thomas. Appreciate you joining us, buddy, and take care.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Adam Long, good to see you back, man. How are you, buddy?
Doing well, and I hope you are as well.
Yes, thanks. Thanks for joining us here for the Oscar special. And your category, if you were voting, Best Actress, am I right?
That is correct.
All right, well, who would you vote for and why?
Carey Mulligan for Promising Young Woman. Big fan of this film. And I think that the reason I would vote for her is the range that the role requires. I think she projects a disarming sense of sweetness during the film. It's coupled with and I apologize, I have some notes here, so I'm cheating a little bit, but
that's okay.
This is coupled with a fierce intensity of the intellectual variety, her sweetness, and then you have this intensity that's kind of an intellectual intensity, I guess you would say. Yeah. And then underneath all that, you have a there's like a sense of rage that's getting ready to boil over like a pot on the stove or something. And I don't know, she just juggles all those balls and does it in a very interesting way. You know, she's also able to project vulnerability as well. In her tender scenes with Bo Burnham.
Yeah, so absolutely.
I think it's a performance that's of its time, obviously. And, you know, big fan of this performance. And for me, it was the one that resonated the strongest with
me. Awesome. There's your vote. Again, what's the name and what's the movie?
Promising Young Woman. And we'll go with Carey Mulligan. That's
all right.
That's the one for me.
All right. And we're asking everybody as well, if you could vote for Best Picture, what would be your vote? Not asking you why, but who would you vote for?
It would be Minari. You know, I know we're not going to get into the whys, but Minari is my choice.
Awesome. Adam Long, thanks for joining us right here on the Oscar special for Meet Me at the Movies. We appreciate you, and we look forward to having you back again soon.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
Mr. Jason Black, the man in black, but you're not wearing black today. You know, you're not wearing green either. You've got incredible tux jackets that I never know what you're going to wear. And today I'm showing you off. So there you go. Thanks for joining us for the Oscar special. And you've got the category that I think people have been dying for, is the best actor category. So let me get your thoughts on who you would vote for and why.
Well, I love the Anthony Hopkins, the father performance. I mean, to me, really, it's the performance of the year, regardless of category. We all know how talented he is. I mean, he's a trained theater actor and has done great in movies. But gosh, the performance he puts in with the Alzheimer's, the dementia, I mean, whatever it's actually diagnosed as, I thought he was just fabulous.
Yeah, and it's amazing. I remember talking to somebody about this back at the beginning of award season when I saw that, and I said, this is probably his best performance. And that's saying a lot, because you look at the body of work that he's got, but it was incredible. But in this year, he's probably not going to win, but he is getting your vote for
this.
He's
getting my vote. Yeah. No, I think it's a lock that Chadwick Boseman wins, but yes, I do. And actually, it's a really good category. But that's my vote. But I do not expect for Anthony Hopkins to walk away with the Oscar, his second Oscar.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate you chiming in on that. And we're also asking people to give us their choice for Best Picture. We'll tally that up at the end of the show. So what is your Best Picture vote?
My Best Picture this year is Trial of the Chicago 7. I'm a bit of a Sorkin fanatic, and I love the dialogue. Yeah, everybody's too old to be playing those parts, but otherwise, I really enjoyed the movie. I thought it was great.
Jason Black, man, thanks so much for joining us. We're glad to have you for the Oscar special right here on Meet Me at the Movies, and we'll bring you back on Meet Me at the Movies later if you'll join us.
Hey, you got it.
All right, thanks, man.
All right, buddy.
The Best Director category this year for the Oscars is incredibly diverse, and every nominee is worth it. Every single one of them is worth it, in my opinion. And the films are pretty diverse as well. The one I'm drawn to, though, for the best director goes to David Fincher. That's who I'm voting for the movie Mank. It's a film that's been years in the making. Fincher's dad, Jack, originally wrote the script for this based on a true story about the writer of Citizen Kane. And his dad passed away. Fincher's dad passed away, and then David had to take over the mantle. It took him years to bring this to life, but when he did so to perfection for me. A black and white film starring Gary Oldman, the production design, the cinematography, the costumes, the score, everything clicked for me in this movie. A movie about movie making always draws me in, and this one did so to perfection for me. David Fincher gets my vote for Best Director. Thanks so much to all the critics who joined us today. Very excited to have this collaborative celebration of the Oscars and share our votes for the Meet Me at the Movies Oscar special. And if you've been keeping tally, you will know that The Father received 2 awards, Soul received 2 awards, and for my vote for Best Picture, I am going with Promising Young Woman as well. It speaks volumes. It was a challenging film to watch, a challenging film to engage in, but yet it spoke volumes. So Promising Young Woman gets my vote for Best Picture. And if we're looking at the tally, that means Promising Young Woman wins for the Best Picture right here for Meet Me at the Movies for our votes. It also got three awards, including Best Picture, Screenplay, and Actress. So until next time, Noel T. Manning II thanking you for spending time with us and thanking all of our critic friends for all they've done to be a part of this special. Till next time, that's a wrap.